Wrong. Look, God sent the word out here to heal y'all, bro. He sent the prophets out here to call to y'all, to bring y'all in, bro. That's what we out here to do. Because guess what? We out here for men just like you and you. We out here for men because guess what? Look at our community. Our community jacked up. Is it not wrong? Is it not jacked up? Ain't this the trap? Ain't the bando right around the corner, bro? Ain't this the hood? We got to fix this thing, bro. We can't wait on the white man to come fix it. We got to do it. We got to fix this thing, bro. That's what we come out here to do with the word of God, because God called to his people. He said the men of my nation got to be the ones to come out here and fix the community, bro. We the ones that got to restore the decayed state of our people. You see your people in oppression, that ain't supposed to make you happy. Ecclesiastes 7 and 7. That's why we out here, bro. We all out here pissed off. The men of purple and gold, bro, we all out here pissed off because our people is in oppression. We pissed off that the white man is over us. We mad because the police can come in your neighborhood, shoot you down, and then just go home to his wife and kid, eat a bag of potato chips and a sandwich, and act like ain't nothing happened. We mad about this thing. Read.
Ecclesiastes chapter 7 verse 7. Surely oppression maketh a wise man mad.
Read it again.
Surely oppression maketh a wise man mad.
Wrong, brother, wrong. You hear that, man? It says surely. Not even, there's no doubt about it that oppression don't make a wise man mad.
I got it.
You got a question, man? I'll praise you, man. Look, that's what we out here to do, to answer questions. What's up? Hold on. All right, here we go. That's a great question. After we get done with this, like you're saying, we teaching, right?
Right.
We out here to teach our people. What we gonna do to heal our people consciously, right? All right, I'm finna show you this, right? First of all, give me Zephaniah 2. All right, and I'm glad you said you brought the word consciously, right? Consciously, right? Remember that right now. Remember that word. What we gonna do to heal our people consciously? I'm finna show you, bro. Finna show you, because God got the remedy. I told you we physicians. We out here with the medicine. Right here, watch this. Give me that. Hold on. I'm trying to help him out. The wind blowing. Hold on. All right.
I'm inquisitive.
I'm glad you're inquisitive. Look, I want you to ask questions. I ain't like the pastor to be like, don't ask no questions. No, ask questions, bro.
Zephaniah chapter 2 and verse 1. Gather yourselves together. Yea, gather together. O nation not desired.
Step 1. We got to gather together. It said, gather together, O nation not desired. Wrong, check out this sign. The nation is not desired, it's the 12 tribes of Israel. That's all these people that's on this sign right here. You see that? The West Indian blacks, American blacks, the Haitians, the Puerto Ricans, the Cubans, the Dominicans, Guatemalans. All these folks down here right here ain't desired by the nations of the earth. Now, so now, I'm going to show you how we're going to do this. It said, gather together. Now, watch.
I want you to share.
Now you're gonna say how. Now your question should be, if it gather together, how are we gonna do that?
My question should be, how we should gather together. That was my question.
Oh yeah, and how are we gonna get?
That's not my
okay
question.
Now, but how are you gonna heal the people consciously? Yeah. Now give me Acts chapter 24 and 16. All right. How are we gonna heal the people consciously? Acts 24 and verse 16. All right. Read.
The book of Acts, chapter 24, and verse 16. And herein do I exercise myself to have always a conscience void of offense towards God.
See that? He said we got to have our conscience void of offense toward God. So now this consciously void of offense. What's our offenses toward God? This is going to start to heal our people, right?
Share a conversation with me. Let me take you to a scripture. Go to Psalms 82, verse 6.
That's
how we
deal with consciousness. All right, hold on. Void of offense toward God, okay.
82, verse 6.
You talking about y'all.
No.
Oh, 82, 82,
82,
verse 6.
Verse 6.
All right, we're going to get in scripture with you.
This how we break our people.
All right. All right, let's go here. We're going to go to your scripture, and then we're going to see where you. We're going to see where we at, all right? We're going to see where we at.
That's how we break
the book of Psalms, chapter 82, and verse 6. I have said, ye are God.
Stop.
All right, hold on. And hey, I'm glad you said it, because I'm bringing this out. We're going to bring this out, but guess what now? They said you got to be, the scripture they said before wrong was what? You got to have a conscience void of offense toward God. God said, ye are gods. And you got to be conscious of it. But now, you're right, absolutely. I'm agreeing with you. Now guess what? Now guess what? Now how are we going to be gods if we don't operate godly?
Right.
So now you gotta be a point of offense toward God. True. So now God gonna give you his ways to be like him.
Have we ever been told that we are a God? We've never been told it.
And we ain't been, and
mentality might change. And guess what?
And you're right. I'm with you 100%. I'm with you 100%.
I'm not disagreeing with you.
So we good.
I am God.
So now,
I am God.
So now, guess what?
I'm talking to God.
Now watch this right here. Now watch this right here. Wrong. So now our people need to be told today that God is earth. Read it again. I love that scripture. It's one of my favorite ones. The book of Psalms, chapter 82 and verse 6. I have said, ye are gods, and all of your children. Hold on, read it right. I have said, ye are gods, and all of you are the children of the Most High. But ye shall die like men.
Because you don't know who you are.
Now, hold on.
You don't die like men in the street because you don't know.
Watch this, though.
Robbers, killers, thieves, murderers, drug dealers, gangbangers. You're going to die in the street.
Because why?
Because you don't know who you are.
Hey, it went back to the scripture I read before.
Yeah,
you
I'm
don't
with
know
you.
Who you are.
I'm with you.
But guess what?
I'm with you.
You don't know how to operate like a God.
Right.
Watch this. You don't know how to live like a God. Watch this. Give me Proverbs 7:2 because does a God die like a man? A God don't die like a regular man, do he?
No.
No, God don't die like a regular man. No. Watch this. A God operates like a God. Therefore, he gonna live like a God. Watch this. Read it.
The book of Proverbs, chapter 7, verse 2. Keep my commandments and live.
God said, do what?
Keep my commandments and live.
That's the life. That's how you gonna live forever, like
God. And you a God.
Right.
He said you a God. Guess what? You're not gonna live like a God. You're gonna die like a man because you don't keep the commandments.
See that power?
If you don't keep the commandments,
I might need it.
Better.
I'm conscious, bro.
So now, what's some of God's ways for you to live tonight? With me. Hold on. So you say you made the generator cut off?
I made the generator cut off. I said, look at the energy from which we...
I was going to say, cut it back off. Right.
I'm saying the energy that we got can't hold this technical shit. That's what I'm talking about.
Which was Solomon, chapter 2, and verse 23. For God created man to be immortal.
So now, God created man to be immortal. Watch this, read.
And made him to be an image of his own eternity.
He made us to be an image of his own eternity. That's why in Psalm 82 he said, ye are God. He created you to be immortal. But now, read on.
Nevertheless,
wrong, what happened?
Through envy of the devil.
Through envy of the devil. That means going against God's commandments, going against his ways. Read.
Came death into the world.
That's why you die like a man. So guess what we come out here to do? Restore the decayed state of our people. We come out here to restore God's commandments back to our people, to show them you are God. This is how you live godly, because God saved you his ways. Now,
in order for our people to understand their Bible, they know their Bible is holy.
Hey, look here.
Symbols, signs, and symbols.
Hey, look, I'm finished. Oh, you said the signs. I'm finna show you some signs. I'm finna show you some signs right now. Give me Deuteronomy 28, verse 46.
I'm asking for you to show me. I'm telling you.
Hey,
my people don't got no understanding of that book or they're reading it.
But guess what?
Face value.
Wrong. Okay. My people are wrong. Hold on.
They think it's a child.
Okay, no wrong. You here, you telling me this, right?
They think it's a child.
But you here.
Right.
And you got some understanding, right?
I got an overstanding.
Okay, so now, okay.
I got you.
All right. So now, their conscience got to be void of offense toward God. That means you got to learn God's commandments. And you say the signs, then it's my signs. They got to be decoded. Hold on, let me show you how to decode the Bible right quick. Give me Isaiah 28. Let me show you how to decode this Bible.
Psalm
111 and 10. Yeah, Psalm 111. That's better. That is actually better. Give me Psalm 111 and 10. So this is how you're going to understand this Bible and learn how to decode it. It's steps, right? It's steps to this thing, right? Yeah, this is a big old book right here. You think it ain't no instructions, anything? All right, watch this. Read.
The book of Psalms, chapter 111 and verse 10. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom.
First of all, you got to learn and understand to fear God, the creator of everything. If you don't fear that, the power, you ain't got no wisdom. So read it again.
The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom.
The beginning of your wisdom. Read.
A good understanding.
That's what we're talking about, how to understand this Bible, right? A good understanding.
Have all day that do his commandments.
Wrong. It was one word that was in there that was powerful. A good understanding have all they that what? Read it again.
A good understanding have all they that do his commandments.
A good understanding is going to come to the people there. Do his commandment. Two-letter word. Huge meaning. Huge implications in that word do right there. You got to put that thing into action. So God is telling you right now, in this book that got the signs and you got to say it got to be decoded and all that, you're not going to have no understanding if you don't do his commandment. So wrong. I'm going to give you a commandment. Simple commandment. Now, to fear God is to fear what? His judgment. God is known by the judgment he execute. You got to fear the judgment. All this stuff right here. Slave ship. Yoke of iron on your neck. Being killed in the street. Oppressed by every nation. You got to fear that. God said, a good understanding have those that are going to do his commandment. Let's show you that. Give me Leviticus 21, 5. So, alright, I'm here with you, Rome.
I want to share a conversation.
All right, I'm gonna give you
a lot of scripture.
No, I'm gonna shoot you this because
I'm with you.
I want you to get this understanding.
I'm with you, and I'm gonna let
you speak after this one. All right, I got you. Read
Leviticus chapter 21 and verse 5.
Read on.
This is part of to do his commandments. If you're gonna do this or not, gonna tell me if Rome got any wisdom and I can share conversations.
Right.
Read.
They should not make boldness upon their head. Neither shall they shave off the corner of their beard, nor make any cuttings in their flesh.
I think you got the beard, right? You got a little razor. You know why you got them dirt? Read it again.
They shall not make baldness upon their head, neither shall they shave off the corner of their beard.
Shave your beard wrong. It said what?
Neither shall they shave off the corner of their beard.
Neither should you do that thing. That's a commandment that you're breaking. It said, neither shall you shave off the corner of your beard. You shouldn't be doing it. That's one of God's commandments, one of his ways to go say, if Rome hear this law right here, come out and say, you know, I'm going to stop shaving my beard. Because God said so, that's how he want me to live. That's going to show that Rome got some wisdom. And I can continue having this conversation with you. I'm saying, I just brought the law out, and the previous scripture said a good understanding of this Bible have all they to do his commandments. Can you do that commandment wrong? Can you stop shaving your beard?
That ain't no problem.
I'll pray to the Most High. So only time I'm going to tell them whether...
If that'll give me a conversation with you, if I got to shave my beard so we can
politic. No, you don't have to. You don't shave your beard till we can politic now.
If I keep a beard so we can politic and grow.
Right. And I'm going to tell you why that's essential, because for God said, we can't come together and be on two different things. Give me that Amos 2 and 3. Watch this. Amos 3 and 2. And we got no, I gotta bring the word of God out, because my words ain't really holding no weight. All right, what you got to say?
We got to show
up. Hold what you got. Get what you got, and then, wrong. Now what you got to say?
Like I said, you got to wake the people up and know we guys, man. You know what I'm saying? Our imagination, our creation, our self-conscious is what wakes us up and activates that this is good. But we made in the image. What you looking for? You are the image. You are God. Wake up and activate the God that's within you. You are the image.
Are we coming out here with religion? Are we reading what God says? I'm making sure. I know it's education. Make a distinction on whether we on the same page.
We on the same page.
All right. So this ain't religion.
My brother called me over.
You're right.
Come politics because he know I'm conscious.
All right. So now, all right. Well, you, I ain't want to cut you off. I just make sure we rule you.
All right.
Read what you got.
I want to see what you feel.
Book of Amos, chapter 3 and verse 1. Hear this word. Then the Lord has
done.
You two walk again.
Amos 3 and 3.
Wrong, check me out. So now, why I brought that law out, and you said now you can keep that law, and I said now we can start beginning to build the politics, right?
I follow the laws of the universe. I don't follow the laws of the universe.
See, that's where now we start going left field, because some of them want to be like, hey, the universe and the ancestors. No, we talking about the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob.
We talking about the Israelites. Make you treat me right. I'm going to treat you whatever it takes to make you be right.
All right, so now, listen to this, bro, and then I'm going to let you speak.
Right. Whatever make you respect me, this I'm cool with you.
Look, listen to this, and then we're going to rap, all right? Ain't no disrespect, but listen to this.
The book of Amos, chapter 3, verse 3. Can two walk together except they be agreed?
Now, can two walk together except they be agreed?
Hold on.
It's the question, man. Read it again.
Can two walk together except they be agreed?
That question is rhetorical right there. Meaning, but I can't be like, okay, me and you, we try to go into business together, right? But you a thief.
Right.
I can't go to business with you.
No,
how we gonna work that out? Because you on thievery and I'm on
He'll never change.
You feel me?
Your judgment of character is he'll never change. A thief will never change.
Now, look, always... I'm saying you are actively right now a thief. Okay. I'm not going into business with you, bro. You feel what I'm saying? Like, now two walk, can't walk together like this. We got to be on the same thing. We come together. Why are all these men right here? All these men different. Gang members, we different. Fat, all type of stuff going on out here, bro. How we together right now? Because we dropped it, now we under one banner. Now, God's wrong. That's what we under right now. The Black Messiah. That's what we under right now.
We used to scream Black Power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission. Minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road. Purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.